Sometimes. You realize you're not in control of life. Just chill out. Stop trying to control everything. SubhanAllah. So this is one of the last things on my final section to share with you. This discussion. And that is, I mean, personally, even though there's more elaborate descriptions and divisions made by scholars, classical scholars, of sadness, I would like to describe or divide, generally speaking, the emotion of sadness into three categories. There's sadness that you brought upon yourself as a result of something you've done. It's your fault. And you know that. That's sadness you brought upon yourself. Then there's sadness brought upon you by others. Something they said, something they did, somehow they had an effect on you, and that brought sadness upon you. And the third circumstance of sadness is a sadness that's a result of a circumstance. You can't even blame a person. It could be something like a car accident. It could be like an earthquake. It could be anything. You know, it could be a sickness. It could be whatever. And these kinds of, so there are these three circumstances. And the first circumstance, what was it again? What was the first circumstance? Something you've done yourself, and you're depressed about something you did. A lot of people have that. My recommendation is to you, for you to carefully study the dua made by Musa alayhi salam. And you'll notice, as I talk, you'll notice that I keep trying to illustrate to you the subject of my talk was the Quran's remedy for sadness. There's not one, there are thousands of remedies in the Quran for sadness. But I keep alluding to the fact that every time I get close to talking about a solution, what comes up? Dua. Every time I start talking about a solution, what comes up again? Dua comes up. Adam alayhi salam was sad, what did Allah give him? Allah gave him a dua. You know, you have Ilyas alayhi salam, really in a state of depression, sadness, and he says, I will only complain to Allah azza wa jalla. Right? So you have these prophetic situations and they all turn into duas. Now this dua is which prophet? When you made a mistake yourself? Musa alayhi salam. I'm sure you've done some pretty bad things, but I'm pretty sure you didn't punch a guy and he died. Don't raise your hand, please. There's police here, just relax, okay? they're not here, you didn't have to check. Okay. So, Musa alayhi salam has done this really bad mistake. And he's, now you know, those kinds of mistakes can haunt you for life. You know, soldiers come back from the battlefield having killed innocent people and they end up committing suicide. Really, they're broken psychologically because of the atrocities they have committed. They relive those moments over and over again. When you've done something wrong, you are one of the victims. You're not just the criminal, you actually, Allah makes you suffer internally for that. You pay the price. But even if it was an honest mistake, in the case of Musa alayhi salam, he had guilt of taking another life. It's not something easy to swallow, it doesn't leave you alone. But Allah gave him, inspired him with this beautiful dua. رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. That is actually the key to moving on with life. If you've made a mistake and you don't know how to move on with life, learn from the dua of Musa alayhi salam. Master, no doubt about it, me, whatever good you send my way, I am desperately in need, my back is broken, I am not capable, whatever good you send my way, I can use it. Let me explain what we mean by good here. Good means two things. Ya Allah, give me good opportunities in life. Ya Allah, don't let the mistake I made make the rest of my life a bad, you know, experience. Don't give me sadness after sadness after sadness. Give me positive experiences and good opportunities in life. By the way, right after that dua, Musa alayhi salam got a job in the next ayah. Right, he made that dua, next ayah he got hired. And married. One ayah. It's pretty awesome. And that next ayah starts with a fa, which means therefore. Therefore, the girl came, called him to the dad, he told the story, she said, I'd like to, you know, let's hire him, and, you know, the whole thing worked out. But all as a result of his dua. What we're learning, that because that little fa in the ayah in Surah Al-Qasas, is that duas can have a serious impact on the rest of your life. Where am I going to find a job? I'm homeless, I'm a fugitive from the law, I ran away from Egypt, I don't even know my way around here, I'm just sitting by a puddle of water. You know, I don't even, my shoes are torn up, my clothes are beat up, I'm sitting under a tree, I don't even know if this tree belongs to someone that kicks me out of here. Next thing, I just, ya Allah, send some good my way, boom, got a job, married a girl, moved in, 8-year visa, set. Everything, set. Tamaniya hijaz, really, sarili ayat, you got an 8-year visa to live in Madian. You know, housing, everything paid, covered. It was sweet. And what a job interview, it was a side note, but what a job interview. He goes to the girl's father and he says, I killed someone, I run away from there, I'm homeless right now. And 2 minutes later he's saying, you should marry my daughter and you should live here. That just proves Allah makes things happen. You don't make the rishta happen.
Prepare for your future, but knowing nothing's going